This is a genuine support from the archangel coming in with a lot of compassion into your life, asking you to get a weight off your chest. Hello, Scorpio. Welcome, new viewers, cross watchers, and my lovely, lovely moonians. Thank you so much for being here. This is a monthly reading for April 2020. We will be looking into love and whatever else that comes through. So let's see what the guides are saying to you. What is coming in for April 2020? Thank you so much. All right. So we have Two of Cups coming in, rejoicing together, partnership in alignment with the soul, which is coming in over here. Agreeing on something is coming in very, very strongly over here. Coming on the same page and taking a new plunge into love is also what is coming in. A higher, a more deeper love that is coming through over here. We have faith also coming in over here, which is really, really lovely. And this is talking about trust as to whatever is meant to be with you will be with you, or whoever. Whatever is meant to be in your life will be in your life. And trust for this relationship to grow, especially if you really have a genuine soul connection with the other person. And it's a very healthy, nurturing, supportive relationship that you're in. Trust in this relationship is the energy which is coming in. Six of Wands is talking about progress. So if there was someone who was a little indecisive, they will be charged up, motivated to come towards you because they have genuinely strong feelings for you. We have Ten of Wands coming through, which is talking about someone who may be a little stressed out by the other things in life, a lot of responsibility or a lot of stress which has been going on, and they're trying to navigate through this. But I do see a little bit of weight which needs to be lifted off. Taking on too much responsibility, wherein you can share it with the other people also a little bit during a little stressful time that you may be experiencing right now, because there's too much on your platter which you need to diversify, divulge a little, or remember to take time off for yourself as well during this time. And apart from that, this does talk about the fact, like, you know, emotionally they are ready, but physically in their 3D realm, there's something which is really stressing them out. So give them the time to come towards you, or, like, you know, be on the phone, or if you are together, living together, then this is talking about there's more nurturing which is coming through. And even if they are stressed out because of work perhaps, they still are very happy to be with you. You are their comfort zone. You are their happy place is the energy which is coming in. We have the Hermit card coming in reverse, which is a Virgo Major Arcana. And the stress, this is coming in more 3D reality, 3D realm. And this is more spiritual realm which needs to be tapped into. They have the potential, but they haven't really embarked on their spiritual journey, or certain kind of retreating from the society which is essential. But the stress and how they are portrayed in the world is really stemming a little bit of doubt or anxiety in them, fear in them also, or a bit of lack that they may be facing. A little bit of dark night of the soul energy which is coming through, which may be causing one to feel a little tired from the current ongoing situations, and that they can't take it anymore, or they just want to be away from all of this for some time. They just require some break. That is the energy which is coming in. We have the High Priestess also coming through, which is talking about you also utilize your higher knowledge. Spiritual aspect is also something which is coming in. You needn't chalk out like an hour to meditate, but while you're doing any kind of housework also, because most of us are on a lockdown during this time. This is talking about even when you're doing that, put on some instrumental music or some kind of particular frequencies which are good for the chakras or positive vibrations. There are many. Use that. Just listen to that and keep doing your work is also what is coming in. Allow the vibrations to do their part while you do the work that is upon you. in the house also. That is the energy which is coming in. We have King of Swords coming through, which is a very, very nice energy, because even if they are stressed right now, they're thinking very practically, rationally also, which is why they can be very soft and nurturing with you while a little stressed in their daily life as well, or in terms of work, which is why they can bifurcate and they're not merging it together, or the frustration from work is put upon you. That is not coming in. That's a very, very good sign of a strong personality, of a very wise soul as well. And we have Five of Wands coming in reverse, which is really, really interesting. And we have the Six of Wands over here, which is talking about letting go of the stress, or realizing that we are focusing on the stresses a little too much, taking away the attention, taking away the power of the situation by taking away our attention, and realizing that whatever obstacle that is coming through right now isn't really that big, and you can overcome it. And with that, we have the Six of Wands also coming in, talking about becoming motivated, determined to be persistent in your pursuit and to just keep moving forward and not let any kind of stress, doubt or fear limit you anymore. Both are getting that energy. What I see over here is that for someone to really take into consideration what they're feeling and merge it with their thoughts while articulating. Over here, what I see is that with faith and love coming in, a little bit of meditation, tapping into your altered state, reflecting upon certain situations, healing, releasing past energies, experiences will really help you advance in your spiritual journey. And with that, more calmness will come through, more knowingness will come in. Know that this is a very genuine relationship that you're in. If you are in a toxic relationship, this is what is coming in, like in the sense you are inviting a very much stronger person who will be very loving towards you irrespective of what they are going through. Yes, there may be a little bit of pilferation which comes through from time to time. We are only humans, but they don't like to merge that together. And just because they are angry, they'll burst on you. That is not their way of going about things. Unless and until the stress is a little too much, that they have gotten a little tired by it, that they become a little unaware of how they're speaking. But overall, this is a very rewarding relationship that you will be tapping into once you free yourself from the hostile relationship that you may be in. It's something that you need to be aware of. We have Papa Legba with strength also coming through, and this is talking about any kind of obstacle that may be there, any kind of stress which may be there, sudden news that came in. Don't stress out yourself. Whatever has to work out will work out. And perhaps it's something which is beyond your control. So why stress about it anyway? And instead, be open to the result of it, but at the very same time, become empowered in your own being. So irrespective of whatever comes through from that undecided fate kind of a thing which is there in front of you, you are prepared to handle it, whether it is of taking action in the same direction because it worked out for you, or in another direction because you chose something different which was there for you. Irrespective, you have to be ready to take action, and this is the prep time that you're getting. We have Nine of Spirals coming through, same energy, a lot of stress which is going on, taking too much work, has been working a little too much and now is getting a little tired of it. There could be a little bit of guilt of the way things were, and if they blurted out unexpectedly on you, they are feeling a little sorry about that as well. And someone may be feeling a little hurt by what the other person said, and know that, you know, they will come through and apologize as well. It's just that whatever the scenario may be in their life, apart from you in their life, it may be very overwhelming for them, and they're not being able to find a nice way of letting it out. So there's a little bit of pent up energy which is there, and they're not being able to see where they have to go. They're a little unclear about that and feeling very dark, or feeling very clouded in their mind, is the energy which is coming through. And we have Archangel Gabriel coming in with fifth chakra, throat chakra. This is a genuine support from the Archangel coming in with a lot of compassion into your life, asking you to get a weight off your chest and reflect, realize, release certain things out of your life, get a closure, and then speak what is within your heart is what is coming through. Have you been hesitant in life or of recent that you haven't been able to speak what's in your mind? Speak clearly, communicate clearly. Whatever you're saying is being heard by the universe. So be aware of that, very much aware of that. Because the negative things also that you're saying, even if it's pun intended, the pun will not be understood by the universe because it will be a transmission that you make into the universe, and they are coded words which go out, imprinted into the universe. So what are you saying? Become aware of that. Be very aware of that. Very, very aware of that. Don't joke about death. All right? Just one thing which is channeled in suddenly. We have Archangel Michael. Both of them have come in reverse, which is very interesting because we have a stronger connection which is required. Also, the way you are conveying or connecting with the spiritual realm, with the source, with the spirit, and with others, people around you as well. Becoming aware of that, being open to listen to what the other people have to say as well, and not just get caught up in your own words. That is something that you may like to think about. Over here, what is this saying is that, and in terms of job as well, like, you know, transitions, some cutoffs happening and all of that. 2-3 friends of mine have spoken about it. So that's why I'm also saying that. But apart from that, this is saying that, oh my God, how many times have I used that? Okay. This is saying bring a little more stability in your life and know that whatever is being cut out of your life is no longer serving its purpose anymore. And there's certain kind of endings which are inevitable and they are for your higher good. So maybe if there is a job thing which is going on, which is causing you stress, even if there's no job, like not this job anymore, because it wasn't really worth it. It wasn't overly using you. That is also something which is coming through. And you need a job which also respects you is something which is coming through. Or generally in life, relationship also, that was too much job which was going on, because I just did Sagittarian and their profession life was coming on very strongly. So just channel through over here. I do see self-reliance, which is coming in very strongly. Using your skill of communication to your power and knowing when to draw the line with the sword over here. All right. So we have Lady, enjoy growth and reap rewards, which is coming in over here. So recognition, which will be coming in, acknowledgement, which will be coming through as well. With the apple over here, new seeds which are being sown, and also reaping the rewards of the trees that you've sown and you have nurtured over the years. There will be a few too many rewards which will be coming in terms of in April itself or beyond that too. The phase is opening up. The hard work that you've been putting in, the remuneration or the recognition, the rewards will be coming through. We have Stargazer, set your sights higher, coming in. Very interesting. Like in terms of communicating, also affirming stronger things for your life, knowing that you deserve it and doing things accordingly. If you are in a toxic relationship, this is exactly coming in for you. Set higher standards and see how with that upliftment or the upgrade that you do, because you are valuing yourself highly, other people will be reciprocating the same energy and treating you accordingly, because what is within is reflected outwards as well. So be aware of that. We have Arrow, surrender yourself with protective energy. Yes, with all these things which are happening during this time, it will be very essential to protect yourself, be safe, stay home, and take care of your loved ones also. And if you can, sage your house once a week. It's usually once a month or twice in a month, but once a week if you have sage, do that. Just be aware of the thing is that the thing which I said, like, you know, be aware of what you're saying, even the negative things that you're saying in jokes. Why allow those things to come through, you know? Because your words are very powerful, so why not understand that and utilize it in a more beneficial way? It's something that you may like to think about. We have Knight, be brave and honest, stand your ground energy again over here. See, what I see over here, there's a cup which is over here, chalice over here or whatever it is called, and we have a rose which is growing another bud over here, and over here we just have one bud. So one aspect of life is flourishing, is giving rewards, they are enjoying it, giving them a lot of relief, wherein the other side of another aspect of their life is starting anew. So maybe the transformation may be very drastic, but at the end of it, when you replace it with something more beneficial, you'll see why that change had to come or that ending was due. We have Water Guardian coming in, connect with your emotions coming through, expressing your emotions, what you're feeling, truly feeling with the other person and this person also to you. Heart-to-heart conversation, which is very important. What are you feeling? What are your thoughts? Are they merging together or should we bridge the gap now is also which is coming through. We have Medicine Guardian, be open and to healing information. All right, so this is really interesting. Maybe sage in your house will be very, very beneficial. If you have pink rock salt and you are, what is that called? Cleaning your house with water, use that a little. It will be very beneficial. Overall, this is saying, like, you know, fill your life with healing, nurturing energies, positive energies within you and around you also. So that is what is coming through. Give some time with plants, spend some time with plants, growing them. Do some changes in the house perhaps. Realign your closet if you can. Something like that. These things also, sometimes we end up having a lot of static energy in our house. So sometimes to move at least like 27 things in the house makes a difference also. It's very beneficial too. And it changes the energy in the room also. Just something which I'm seeing. We have Trader, exchange energy to create abundance. This is so interesting. Whatever I'm seeing in the second row, it's like cut, 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 cut coming through. So we have a little bit of healing which is required. There's certain kind of still, even if you feel that you have overcome it, but if you still keep on talking about it or from time to time go to that place and while expressing, especially when you're talking about it, you feel the same emotions all over again. That is a sign that there's still a part which is not healed. And consciously we have to start with the healing by first forgiving ourselves for whatever was experienced. All right. And then we have some recreational energy which is coming through, changing the dynamics of the house a little, doing certain things which bring in a lot of positive energies, having herbal tea as well, having a bath with rose petals, salts, bath salts, using a little bit of kapoor, which is camphor, burning it to bring in good energy, or just having some aromatherapy thing going on in the house. It will really, and just thank the house for being there and giving so much protection and a shelter to this phase, the day, the winter and the rains and everything. Just thank the house, you know, just a little bit of that also. Gratefulness for what you have in life is something which is coming through. Enjoying the now, enjoying the blessings in life. Yes, there are some kind of complications which are going on, stresses which are there, but what are you focusing upon? Paying attention to is what will make the difference. That is what is coming through. So become aware of the energy that you're extending into your relationships, into your friendship, into the universe, because that is the exact energy which will be coming back to you as well. So hopefully create beautiful ripples of love and light so that they come back into your life in manifolds too. And invite abundance, new opportunities, love and insight to come into your life each and every day and fill your life with positive energies and joy. Until next time, do let me know if this resonated with you and subscribe if you haven't already. And please do subscribe to the channel and like the video and share it with the loved ones. Comment if you can, because it helps YouTube understand that this is a genuinely good video that people would like to hear and see and all of that. And thank you so much for being part of the Moonian family. You are loved very, very dearly. So until next time, my precious, precious Scorpion darlings, love, light, abundance, clarity, strength to you all. A lot of strength to you all. Until next time, Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely Moonians.